Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 1807, Offsheet Data Validation Backwards Compatibility. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question sent in by Fred. Fred has a really cool spreadsheet, and when I looked at that spreadsheet, Fred has one data validation cell right here somewhere, and he allowed a list, and I was surprised to see that he just clicked here in the source and selected sheet 2 and this range. All right, never, it used to be that you could not point to another sheet using data validation, but hey, it's working, right? It's really cool. And all right, good, great. So they changed that somewhere along the line, I don't know where. Here we are in Excel 2010, clearly it's working here. Ah, but then Fred then shared that with his friends and coworkers, and he reported back that people on a Mac are not seeing the dropdown. I'm also betting that people in Excel 2003, Excel 2002, and Excel 97 aren't seeing the dropdown either, because back then you weren't allowed to have validation pointing to another sheet. Ah, but there was a workaround. Here's what you have to do. Now, the first thing I did is selected this validation. I did Alt-E-A-A to completely clear that cell. Then we're going to come back here to where the list lives. We're going to select the list and name this list. One word here, I don't care, product list, prod list, but no space, right? I'm just going to call it P-list, like that, P-list. So now that is a named range. Now that that named range exists, and it's a global named range, in other words, it has a workbook scope, every single sheet thinks that P-list lives on that sheet. So we're allowed to come back here now and do Alt-DL for data validation. We're going to allow a list, and the source is going to be equal P-list. Click OK. Now here we are in Excel 2010. It's going to work just like it worked in when we pointed to the sheet without using a named range. The difference is going to be when Fred shares this with his friends who have Macs or Excel 97, then the data validation will continue to work because we're using a named range instead of pointing to a different sheet. Now, hey, it's really cool that the folks out at Microsoft found that this was a problem and fixed it somewhere along the way, and provided you and all your friends are on Excel 2010 or newer on a Windows PC, hey, it's great. But knowing this cool little backwards compatibility trick, in case you're sharing your workbooks with someone who is using Excel on a Mac or Excel 97, is a good thing to know. I want to thank Fred for sending that question in. I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.